Hey, what's up guys, Pog here, and today I will be picking up the all new refreshed 2022 Tesla Model X Long Range. I have ordered the car last year summer. I ended up selling my C-Class because it was supposed to be here in January. I sold it, it got moved to February, then August. The dates were everywhere. This is also the third appointment for delivery, not the estimated date. It was scheduled for April 20th, April 29th, because the car didn't arrive. I found the car on lot on the 28th. Today's May 3rd, and I was actually unsure if I would actually pick the car up today or if they had to reschedule it. I'm really excited. I don't know if you guys can see from my voice, but waiting almost a year, it's crazy. And I went through so much because when the Model 3 got in an accident, it was actually really tough because I just sold the C-Class and we were already short one car. Then the Model X didn't come in January. We got the Model 3 fixed on February. It was pretty tough. And just a huge tip, do not sell your car until you take delivery of your Tesla. Do not believe the estimated days, trade it into Tesla or take delivery and then sell your car. Huge mistake from my end for selling my car in November, expecting the January date to be when I would get my car. Let's get going. Thankfully, I do have my dad with me. Also got the required documents, license plate, insurance has already been uploaded. Yeah, these lights look much nicer. Wow.
So you got all your keys here. How do you feel about the yoke steering wheel on your side of
You know, I've been driving the Model 3.
Yeah.
Pretending it doesn't have a top.
Okay, for so a couple you're just months. Trying to get used to it?
It just looks weird.
It is. It is.
But it's cool.
It is super cool.
The windshield is my favorite. I think it was worth the wait.
Yeah, it's 100% worth the wait. It's always worth the wait.
I know it's gonna take a while to get used to pulling it from here.
Yeah.
This looks a bit weird.
It does look weird.
Could you customize the screen on these ones or no?
As far as I know, no.
It's got the cooling seats too, right? I'm guessing this.
Yeah.
It's like my brain is not functioning properly.
No, it's okay. Yeah, so auto-cooled seats.
And then you change it to heat.
Yeah.
I like it.
It's good. Good, I'm glad.
I mean, the rear visibility is better than the Model Y.
Oh, 100%.
I would say.
Yeah.
First car with a spoiler that's visible. I'll have a sit in the back.
Yeah, go for it. So, I mean, feel free to play around if you okay. need any. You have any questions? I'll just be standing right there.
All right. It's got the screen in the back. Disney Plus already updated. Heated seats in the back, including the middle seat. This part is definitely an interesting experience. Not sure why I did that. It's got a light there. I guess to light up the walkway. Take a look at the frunk. These are actually force touch. Thank you. Look, it's good. You like it? Just come here. Sit. Wait. You like it? Let's go home.
Let's go home.
So I have been driving the Model X today for quite some time and I did end up taking a couple trips. I've also noticed quite a bit of issues with it. The majorest one is actually the driver side Falcon Wing door. So if I just try closing this, as you can see, it is actually not gonna close. The only way I can close it is by doing it twice. So see, it's gonna open and then I do it again, now it will close. But look right there, as you can see, there's actually a wear on the headliner because it is rubbing right there. You hear that squeak? And if you look, the handles do not line up. I'm loving this car, but that's a big issue right there with the Falcon Wing door. Not sure if it has to do with the trunk here. If you look here, it is not aligned properly, as you can see on the roof where the Falcon Wing door is. It is sticking out. Rubber seal here, it's much, much smoother. Whereas on this one, it is not, it keeps squishing it like that. If I open the tailgate, this is something that I've noticed. These right here, they look so cheap. I mean, I don't know what this is, if it's supposed to be like this. Okay, and then you look at this one, it's much better. Look at this thing, it is a bit sharp. And it's like a turning thing. It just does not look like it's OEM. It does have a lot of space here at the tailgate, so you can store a lot of things. This part here opens up, more storage, it's pretty deep. Then there's this part over here with a 12 volt outlet. Then we have the bumper here. I don't know if you can see, but it seems like there's more gap on the driver's side than the passenger side. I did end up booking a service appointment on the app. That's gonna be a mobile service. They're gonna come to the house. Hopefully they can fix it there. They don't have to book a service appointment that I have to take it to Tesla. I love the windshield, I really do. The yoke, I'm actually getting used to it. The seats are pretty comfortable. The only thing I've noticed is the turn signal. So like if I try to indicate going at a roundabout, it is extremely difficult to try to indicate left and right while you're at a roundabout. So that's the biggest thing I've ended up noticing with it. Again, guys, it's such an amazing, amazing vehicle. I love it. It has soft close, so you can do it like this. It'll close the rest of the way. But again, if I open this and then I just kind of stop it, you can see the headliner has a wear right here. So it seems like it's rubbing somewhere here. So this seems a bit outwards, I'm not sure. But again, like, you know, the panel gaps and things like that is not as bad as having a Falcon Wing door that does that, okay? So you can hear it squeak. And on the screen, it actually says an obstacle has been detected, as you can see right there. So now I have to like do that. Can I do it like this? Nope. So you have to wait it open again. And then we're gonna have to push that again. So this time it didn't do the sound, but again, you can see just this over here kind of does not seem right to me, as you can see. Now with Tesla, the later you get it, sometimes it's actually a better car. In this case, I got the newer charge ports, as you can see. It doesn't have that nice glowing circle, so you get the T just like the Model 3 and Y. But again, it is much nicer. Now I think you can use one of those locks that you couldn't back in the day with the S and the X to like stop people from unplugging your car. The taillights look amazing. I like the spoiler. Love how the doors open and present themselves. It did end up raining. It's gonna be really hard to show it. But one thing I noticed, this part is obviously dirty and then this part is clean. Kind of the feeling when you're sitting in the passenger seat and this part is always dirty. That's kind of what it feels like. It's like on top of your eyesight. This armrest being white is also pretty nice. That's the visibility at the back. The spoiler looks super cool. And there's the sunroof for each passenger there. You can recline and fold the seats at the back. Just do these ones, yeah. So I'm not sure how these ones would light up, probably through the touch screen. So yeah, through the touch screen, they did end up turning on. When you hit off, it actually turns it off. Got the camera here. I believe the older X and S didn't have it. The glove box is also super nice. Hazard switch is here. So there's this part here that gives you a storage bin. You close this, there's a deeper storage. And then you do this, you get a cup holder and a storage. This will close that part and you'll still have cup holders. If you don't want it, you can close all of it. It's quite the system. This being magnetic is also super nice. Two USB-C ports right here.
and they charge pretty fast. Sirius XM radio, all that other stuff. You can just end up closing both the doors. And then you push this, it opens the door for you. You can get out and push the button like this and it'll close it. You can also just push the button you push to exit, same button, which is the touch sensitive button. So if I open it and then I touch it, it'll actually close it. And this is why I love white car, because it's so much harder to see the raindrops, all that stuff, all the scratches and swirl marks. If the car was black, the whole car would be like this. I mean, look at the trim piece, which I love how they have it in black, but the paint, it does not look as dirty. The frunk is also really large and it has that tow hook thing, parking sensors. I love the fog lights and everything. I'm definitely gonna do a nighttime review of this car. So I'm gonna show you guys how the lighting and all that stuff looks during nighttime. I think that would be really, really cool. And in case you're wondering, the tires that it came with is the Continental Cross Contact LX Sport, 275 45 R20 at the back and 265 45 R20 at the front. So this was my second Tesla that had the same issue, where they schedule an appointment where you have to pick the car up, you get everything set up, and then they send you a text a day or two before telling you that you can't pick the car up because it hasn't arrived yet. Now with this car, I really expected to pick the car up on the 29th. That's kind of what happened with the Model 3. They rescheduled it and the second day was when I actually picked it up. So when they called me on the 28th, they said, "How are you doing?" And I'm like, "I'm doing good." And they're like, "You don't sound that good." And I'm like, "Probably because you're gonna give me bad news." And the advisor ended up telling me, "Well, it's not really bad news." So I expect the car to be coming on the 29th, and then they said, "Car still hasn't arrived. We're expecting it to arrive today, so we can't do the delivery on the 29th because it still has to go through inspection, and we're gonna move it to the May 3rd." And I was like, "Can you guys do it a bit quicker? Because I really want my car." And they're like, "The Model X is the biggest. It needs the most time for inspection." So they had Friday, which was the 29th of April. And then they had May 2nd, which was yesterday. That was Monday. And guess what? Somehow they still did not figure out that my Falcon Wing door has this issue. That's really what I find stressful, you know, where they have to reschedule like this, tell me that inspection takes a long time. It's their biggest car. And how could they miss that? And now I have to go through process of getting it fixed. And yes, it's under warranty, but on the other hand, I wouldn't be happy if they called me and said the wing has an issue and then they're gonna delay my appointment further. But I just don't think it would have taken them longer than 2 business days that they had the car to actually figure it out and actually fixed it before I took it. I just hope that their quality control and delivery process will get improved. I said similar things for the Model 3 in regards to delivery. I still think they have to get the car on their lot and then schedule delivery. It's kind of strange that they schedule delivery when the car is not even in Canada. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing for lots of Model X, Model Y, as well as Model 3 content. If you have any suggestions, let me know in the comments below. I love having this car in my driveway. It was a dream come true. Even though with all the imperfections, I kind of expected it. I really thought they're not really gonna do anything. I'll see you guys next time.